I remember when I first held the original MacBook Air. I was awestruck by just how thin and light it was and had a hard time believing it was a real computer. My only real complaint was that the hard drive was comparably small, starting at just 80 gigabytes. Fortunately, for those of us that need more than 80 gigabytes, there's a quick and easy do-it-yourself upgrade. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit, and today I'm going to show you how to upgrade the smallish hard drive that came in the original MacBook Air with the roomier 120 gigabyte version. This video is just an overview, and while it's not a difficult swap, you'll still want to follow the step-by-step instructions and the repair guide on our site. I'm going to upgrade this MacBook Air, and as I do, I'll try to give you some tips to hopefully save you some time and prepare you for any of the tricky parts. This is a good time to reiterate that I'm working on the original MacBook Air, so to make sure we're talking about the same computer, double-check the model number of your computer on our site, because different versions of MacBook Air use different parts. I love repairs that don't require a lot of tools, and this is one of them. All you're going to need is a spudger, a Phillips 00 screwdriver, which I got from our 54-piece bit driver kit, and of course, your replacement hard drive. I'm also going to use a screw tray, which isn't totally necessary, but keeps me from mixing up all the different sizes of screws, and that makes reassembly much faster. All these things you can find at iFixit.com. Now that I've got my parts and tools laid out, I can get started. First things first, I'm going to remove all the screws that are holding the bottom case on. And now that all the screws are out, I'm going to start lifting the bottom case down near the vents. And once that's released, I'm going to kind of slide it towards the back of the computer because that releases the little mounting tabs on the inside. You'll hear it kind of click, and then you can just lift it off. Now, just because we can see the hard drive doesn't mean that we can remove it right away. It's near some kind of fragile connectors, and we want to have full access to those. So before we get to the hard drive, I'm going to remove the battery. And there's just a few screws holding it in place. So now that all these screws are removed, I can disconnect the battery connector, and the battery should just lift right out. Now again, before we can remove the hard drive, I've got to disconnect a couple of cables. Some of them I can do with my fingers, like this one on top, and some of them I'll need to use my spudger for. And now that those cables are disconnected, there's a couple screws holding the hard drive in place, and then we can remove it. So now, the hard drive should just lift right out. And the last thing we've got to do is take off the bracket and this little rubber shock absorber and the connector. All that's left to do is attach these pieces to my new hard drive, reassemble my MacBook Air, format the drive, and I'm done. If you need instructions on how to format the drive, we've got a great OS X install guide on our site to help you along the way. Of course, you can find all the parts and tools for this and many other repairs at iFixit.com. And if you run into problems during your repairs, there are lots of solutions in the MacBook Air repair guide on our site. Thanks for watching and happy repairing.